Hello everyone, welcome back to Auto Trend TV. I'm Yuvi Prajesh again from Ramani Mahindra showroom in Coimbatore today, and I'm here with the brand new Mahindra Thar LX top spec petrol automatic variant. Before we get into the drive experience, let's just quickly talk about the exterior and interior. This being the top spec variant, the Mahindra Thar gets LED DRLs along with front fog lamps, 18-inch alloy wheels wrapped in Seat Caesar all-terrain tires, and this car looks exactly the same as the diesel variant, except for the M Stallion TGDI badging on the front fenders, which denote that this is a petrol variant. Apart from that, everything remains exactly the same. You also get the fifth alloy wheel mounted on the tailgate. And this being the hardtop version, you also get a rear windshield defogger, while two reverse parking sensors are standard across all variants. Since the glass opens towards the top separately, a rear windshield wiper is not available. So that was all about the exterior details of India's most favorite SUV currently. Now let's explore the interior. The interior of the top-spec LX petrol automatic looks exactly the same as the diesel. Before I show you other features, let me just show you the flip key. This looks exactly the same as the Mahindra Mirazzo as well. And this being the top-spec LX variant, you also get ESP traction control with hill descent control along with rollover mitigation as standard, apart from the regular safety features such as dual airbags and ABS. Turning on the power, this is how everything looks like. Everything including the instrument cluster and the touchscreen system are carried forward from the diesel variants. And this being the top-spec LX variant, you also get cruise control as standard on the right side of the steering wheel. Coming to the center console, this touchscreen system is much more responsive than before and also gets Android Auto and Apple CarPlay as standard, along with inbuilt navigation. Electronically operated AC controls are also standard across all variants, and the gear lever is also shared with the diesel automatic variant. All variants also come as standard with the 4x4 transfer case, which is controlled electronically using the manual lever. All variants get front power windows only as standard, and there is also a decent number of storage spaces around this cabin. The seats on this LX variant are really comfortable and also get lumbar adjust, along with height adjustment for the driver seat. Talking about adjustment, all variants also get tilt adjustable steering wheel as standard. However, people who have gotten used to driving other cars will notice the absence of a dead pedal, surprisingly even on this automatic variant. While there are provision for the speakers on the dashboard, the Mahindra Thar LX gets roof-mounted speakers as standard, along with LED cabin lighting. The rear seats are reasonably comfortable as well, and also get proper 3-point seat belts, along with ISOFIX child seat mounts. Side-facing seats have been discontinued on all variants in the interest of safety. So that was a quick walkthrough of the interior. Let's just open the bonnet. Opening the extremely heavy bonnet of this Mahindra Thar LX petrol automatic, you get to see a brand new 2-liter 4-cylinder M Stallion TGDI petrol engine, which produces 150 PS of maximum power and 300 Nm of maximum torque through either a 6-speed manual transmission on the lower spec AX variants, while the top spec LX variants get this standard 6-speed automatic gearbox. This petrol engine is claimed to be extremely refined while also being very punchy. And unlike the diesel variants, this petrol version does not get underbonnet damping or insulation materials, which is quite surprising for a car in this price range. Now let's take a drive of this petrol automatic Mahindra Thar to see how does it perform on the roads of Coimbatore. Yes folks, I'm right now inside the brand new Mahindra Thar petrol automatic top spec LX variant, and we are going to start the drive. This here is a 2-liter brand new M Stallion series engine, which is going to be incredibly refined thanks to its petrol nature. And let's just see how does this perform in Coimbatore city traffic and free stretches as well. First of all, let's just start the engine to judge the NVH. Well, the 2.2 liter diesel itself was very refined. This being a petrol, you literally cannot hear anything inside the cabin. It is literally pin drop silent thanks to the additional refinement levels and damping levels. It is incredibly refined as well. And so let's just start the drive. This here is the very same 6-speed Aisin sourced automatic transmission. This is the torque converter unit seen on the XUV500 as well. And yeah, this is a totally different experience. It is incredibly refined, very smooth, and I have no words to say at all. This is a Jeep. This is a sort of a hardcore four-wheel drive SUV, which is incredibly refined without any sort of noise levels on the outside as well as inside. So this is a very unique experience. And since it's quite hot today in Coimbatore, let me just turn on the AC. Just try revving a bit. Yeah,
Well, within no time, I'm doing around 50. So the acceleration is pretty good. This engine produces 150 PS of maximum power and 300 Newton meters of maximum torque. So, as expected, this engine is very, very good in terms of pickup. And the gear changes too are barely noticeable. I hardly notice the gear changes at all. Let me just put my foot down. Wow! I mean, I barely felt that gear change. The pickup is strong. This engine pulls really strong. I mean, only if you cross, say, around 2500, 3000 RPM, you get that faint level of, say, the engine noise. But that's not a noise, it's just a sort of a whoosh kind of a noise. It's very, very soothing. And the refinement, I am still yet to find words to describe the refinement of this SUV, the petrol one. So as you can see, this being a petrol, you obviously get the advantage of BHP. I mean, the diesel was definitely far more torquey, but the petrol is more powerful. So you get the instant pull, the instant punch. And this is a very, very refined transmission as well. I mean, I barely noticed the gear change at any speed. So I'm right now crawling in city traffic. So let's just get to a free stretch and judge this engine better. So yes, folks, driving the Mahindra Thar petrol automatic in Coimbatore city. Well, this here is the rush hour 6 p.m. traffic now. And I actually like this petrol automatic version of the Thar very, very much. That's because the convenience is amazing. You don't get the hassle of a clutch pedal. This automatic transmission also responds very, very easily. As you can see, I'm just putting my foot down. Before that, let me just let the I-20 go away. And now putting my foot down. Well, you can see the surge. I mean, that is that instant torque pull from this engine. Despite being a petrol, this is one torquey heck of a petrol engine. I really love that. And the steering too is incredibly light for such a massive, massive SUV. You can see that the Cretas and all, they seem very, very small against this Thar. That's because this is a massive SUV. And this feels like a very good car driving in Coimbatore. I mean, far better when you compare with the previous generation Thar. That was properly utilitarian, hardcore, focused only towards utility and hardcore mud plugging as against to comfort. But this being more comfortable, the interior is far more insulated. It's better isolated. The driver is very, very isolated. And the suspension too is very, very good. I mean, there is that slight bit of bounciness, while driving at low speeds. Probably because of high tire pressure, but apart from that, it feels properly good. And talking about other features driving in this traffic, you can see this MID over here. This is much better than before. It provides you with a lot of data, including instantaneous efficiency. There is also digital speedometer, and there is also the depiction of the power delivery kind of thing. And there is also other things, including service warnings and all. So this is pretty good. You also get 2 trip meters. That is also good. The speedometer, tachometer, everything is very, very easy and clear to read. You also get this new touchscreen system, which provides you with a lot of data, including adventure statistics such as power, torque, inclinometer, and all those things off-road. There is also an off-road setting for that. So that if you are going off-road, you get to see this inclinometer, the angle of the car and all that, center, all that. And normally you get to see compass as well. So this is also very, very helpful. And apart from that, you get Android Auto, Apple CarPlay as standard. No reverse parking camera though. That's because this is an off-road car. There are reverse parking sensors as standard across all variants though. You also get this car info, which gives you tire pressure monitoring system. That is also incredibly good. You also get BlueSense app connectivity, which you can operate just using your smartphone itself. There is also a smartphone app for that. You get LED DRLs, service warnings, fuel info, all that. There's also distance to empty. This car, being a petrol automatic, is still giving me around 7.5 km per liter in city traffic. That is also very, very good for such a large, heavy petrol automatic SUV. And that's it. Now let me just get to a proper free stretch because it's kind of traffic now. And let's judge this car even better. So right now we have got a sort of a free stretch in, Wadavalli Road over here. And this is rush hour, so this gearbox immediately responds to my throttle inputs. That is a very, very good thing. And within no time, I'm doing 80. So this is very, very well tuned for this 2-liter petrol engine. However, at high speeds, you have to remind yourself that this is predominantly an off-road SUV, and these 18-inch alternate tires are sort of bouncy. This car is bouncy in nature. That you have to keep in mind. But apart from that, on say very, very straight and free stretches, this SUV will perform perfectly fine if you maintain sane speeds, say up to 80 or 100. Beyond that, it is going to be obviously very, very hard to keep this under control. But under such safe, sane speeds, this is going to be very, very good. And for most purposes, yeah, the Thar works perfectly fine, even if you drive it in the city or on highways and even off-road. For off-road, you obviously get the transfer case, which is standard across all variants. You get two-wheel drive high, and you also get four-wheel drive low, four-wheel drive high as well. So that is also going to be very, very helpful if you are driving on serious off-road stretches. So yeah, the Thar is, well, almost a perfect all-rounder if you want a proper SUV. This has become the proper definition for an SUV. That's because it is equally comfortable on the inside, equally capable on the outside and under the hood as well, and also provides all the mechanical stuff you need. So what else do you need? Yeah, you need a lot of petrol. Right now we are in the, say, very narrow road behind Sai Baba Colony, and as you can see, this has been dug up and not covered very, very well. So this is properly very, very rough stretch over here, and on such stretches, well, there is no need for four-wheel drive. But still, talking about the ride quality, it is pretty good, but yeah, it absorbs everything very, very well. Talking about the wheels, the suspension, everything absorbs all the bumps, the ruts, everything very, very well. But the thing is, if you up the speed even on the smoothest of roads, it feels slightly bouncy. As you can see, there is a massive pothole, and I barely feel anything except for that slight thud. And on such narrow roads, it may feel kind of a handful, that thanks to the massive width of this SUV. But it's not like you cannot handle this at all. It is easy. It is easy thanks to this very, very light steering wheel. Well, comparatively light for such a massive SUV. And yeah, it's perfectly fine for bad roads, no roads, even off-road and on roads as well, till you keep your speeds sane. So that's all. Let's go on to the showroom now.
That was a quick drive review of the brand new Mahindra Thar LX petrol automatic variant, which is the first proper body on frame petrol automatic SUV from Mahindra and has quickly become India's favorite SUV, launched in 2020. However, the biggest surprise is the punchy power delivery and refinement of this completely all new turbocharged direct injection petrol engine on such a hardcore off-road SUV, which at this price range can easily rival mid-size crossovers like the Hyundai Creta and the Kia Seltos, while also providing great comfort, convenience and safety. So if you are in the market for a proper off-road capable SUV with incredible levels of petrol refinement and the convenience of an automatic transmission, and if you can afford the petrol costs, the Mahindra Thar petrol automatic is the best choice for you. Meanwhile, this is Viprajesh signing off. See you on another video. Thank you for watching.